Hi friends, welcome to Alpha Mathematical Institute, Avadi, Chennai. Now we will discuss a problem on linear algebra. Let A equal to, it's a 2 by 2 matrix, first row 1, 2, second row 4, 3, belongs to M2 of R, and phi from R2 cross R2 to R, be bilinear map defined by phi of V, W equals to V transpose AW. Choose the correct statement from below. First statement, phi of V, W equals to phi of W, V for all V, W belongs to R2. Second statement, there exists a non-zero V belongs to R2 such that phi of V, W equals to 0 for all W belongs to R2. Third statement, there exists a 2 by 2 symmetric matrix B such that phi of V, V is equal to V transpose BV for all V belongs to R2. Fourth statement, the map psi from R power 4 to R defined by psi of V1, V2, W1, W2 equal to phi of V1, V2, W1, W2 is linear. Actually, in this problem, one bilinear transformation is given whose domain is R2 cross R2, whose codomain is R, right? So that bilinear transformation is defined by phi of V, W equals to V transpose AW, okay, where A is this matrix 1, 2, 4, 3, right? Some statements are given, so we have to choose which statement is a correct statement, right? So let us answer to this question, right? So first we write the given information. So phi of V, W equal to V transpose AW. This is the definition of phi, right? So let us take two elements from R2. It's a vector. So V equals to V1, V2, W equals to W1, W2, right? So let us calculate what is phi of V, W. So phi of V, W equals to V transpose. V transpose means it's a row vector. V1, V2, A into W. A is 1, 2, 4, 3. W is W1, W2, right? So here I have to multiply these two matrices. So first row, first column. First row, first column. So I'll get 1 times V1 plus 4 times V2. And then first row, second column. 2 times V1 plus 3 times V2. Into this matrix W1, W2, okay? So it will become this V1 plus 4 V2 times W1 plus this 2 V1 plus 3 V2 times this W2, right? So I will get phi of V, W is equals to this big expression V1 W1 plus 4 into V2 W1 plus 2 into V1 W2 plus 3 into V2 W2. You call this equation as equation number 1. Okay, so in a similar manner, we have to calculate phi of W, V. So phi of W, V means W transpose AV. W transpose means W1, W2, a row vector. And then A is this matrix 1, 2, 4, 3. V is V1, V2, right? So now you just multiply this matrix and then this matrix and this matrix. You'll get this matrix into V1, V2. So if you multiply these two matrices, we will get this expression. So finally, we will obtain phi of V, W is equal to this expression V1, W1 plus 4 into W2, V1 plus 2 into W1, V2 plus 3 into W2, V2. So you call this as equation number 2. Now you just look equation number 1 and equation number 2, right? So from equation number 1 and 2, we will get phi of V, W is not equals to phi of W, V. So first option is wrong option, right? Now let us go for this one. assume that phi of v comma w equals to 0. So already we know phi of v comma w is this expression. Phi of v comma w means this one, v1 plus 4 times v2 into w1 plus 2 times v1 plus 3 times v2 into w2. So this is equals to 0. So this expression equals to 0. So left hand side is a linear combination of w1 and w2. So I have to make right hand side as a linear combination of w1 and w2. So I am making it as a linear combination of w1 and w2. 0 can be written as 0 times w1 plus 0 times w2. Just to compare the coefficients of w1 and w2 on both sides, I will get these two equations. V1 plus 4v2 equals to 0. 2v1 plus 3v2 equals to 0. Actually, this is a system of two equation, and then this system is a homogeneous system also. Suppose this system has a non-zero solution, then the second option is correct. So let us see whether the system has a non-zero solution or not. So for that, let us form the determinant of the coefficient matrix. So determinant of the coefficient matrix is 1 determinant 1 4 2 3 which is equals to minus 5 which is not equals to 0. So definitely the system has a unique solution, right? Because delta not equals to 0, and then the system is a homogeneous system also. So definitely the system has a unique solution which is given by delta x equal, which is given by x equal to delta x divided by delta. Here delta v1 divided by delta, and then v2 equals to delta v2 divided by delta. So if we calculate delta v1 and then delta v2, it will become 0. So my v1 and v2 equals to 0. So whenever phi of v comma w equals to 0, we will get a trivial solution. V1 equals to 0 and then V2 equals to 0 for all W belonging to R2. Therefore, second option is also wrong option. Okay. So now we will go for the third option. So third option says that phi of V comma V equals to V transpose into BV for some symmetric matrix B. So that existence of a symmetric matrix we have to establish, right? So let us calculate phi of V comma V. By definition, it is V transpose AV. So V transpose means it's a row vector V1, V2. A is 1, 2, 4, 3. V means V1, V2. It's a column vector. You just multiply this matrix and this matrix. You'll get this into this column vector V1, V2. So once if we multiply this matrix and this column vector, so we will get this one. 6 V1 square plus 6 into V1, V2 plus 3 into V2 square. We will get like this. Okay. So actually this is a quadratic form in V1 and V2. So matrix representation of this quadratic form is nothing but V transpose B into V, where V transpose means the row vector V1, V2. B is this 1, 3, 3, 3, and then V is this one, V1, V2. So phi of V comma V equal to V transpose BV, where B equals to 1, 3, 3, 3. Actually, this B is obtained from this quadratic form. How it is obtained means the first entry. This diagonal entries means the coefficient of V1 square and the coefficient of V2 square. And then this entry is half of the coefficient of V1, V2. Here the coefficient of V1, V2 is 6. So half of it is 3. So here this matrix should be symmetric. So here 3 means this entry is also 3. So B equals to 1, 3, 3, 3, which is a symmetric matrix. Therefore, second option is also true option. And then it'll go for the fourth one. So, 5 psi from R power 4 to R defined by like this psi of v1 v2 w1 w2 equals to phi of v1 v2 comma w1 w2. Okay, so let us take two elements, x comma y belongs to r power 4 and alpha comma beta belongs to r. So let us calculate this quantity psi of alpha times x plus beta times y, and then look for this quantity alpha times psi of x plus beta times psi of y. A simple calculation shows these two quantities are not equal, therefore psi is not a linear function. Psi is not a linear function. So correct answer to this question is I think the third option is correct option. Okay, so for more videos subscribe to Alpha Mathematical Institute. Thanks for watching.